Welcome to the Great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael, I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And our topic today is how to walk in the wilderness. But before we start there, please consider to help and support us with the case of baby Grace. We have put a new video on our YouTube channel. And this video, we tell you the total cost per month, how much we cover as Triple Grace in our mission to Cambodia and what we are looking for. So please watch that video with baby Grace and open your heart, come forth, go to our Patreon page and make a donation towards the monthly cost of baby Grace. Let us finish it. We have gotten her through the operation. Now let us also get her through the post-operational treatment. So please come together in love, unity and support and help us. I will put a link to the Patreon page and information about baby Grace in the first pinned comment. Thank you for your donation, your help and your kind heart. Now let us come to the topic. How to walk in the wilderness. Let us take the example of the Exodus, how Moses took the Israelites out of Egypt and how they walked in the wilderness. First of all, they have to walk in unity. They walked in unity as one group together so that nobody was left behind, because anybody that is left behind could be picked out easily by the Egyptians or by the Egyptian forces. So unity is very important. Then of course, when they walked through the wilderness and there was nothing, they had to share resources. That was also important. So whatever they had all together was belonging to the whole group. They had all in common and they shared what they had with everybody who had need. And then they had to support one another. If somebody was fallen down or got injured, he had to be carried by somebody else so that nobody be left behind. So we have unity, we have sharing of resources, and we have support for one another. That sounds very, very familiar. Yes, of course, because you find the same principle in the first Christians, in the first assemblies, in the first churches. That is the same system. At the Israelites was with God the Father, and at the Book of Acts it was for Jesus Christ. So you see, there must be an important lesson that we can learn here about unity, sharing resources and supporting one another. What else do they have to walk in the wilderness? They had to have faith. Without faith, they could not have left Egypt. And they must have protection. Protection from God the Father and the angels. Because in the wilderness, there are a lot of dangers. But they were protected. And they also received many miracles. Like when there was no water, then water came out of a stone. Manna came from heaven. Quails were sent so that they had meat. Many, many miracles. And the miracles came because they obeyed. They obeyed to come out of Egypt and walk that path in unity and in the love of the Father and in support. Now, today, right now, we are also called in our great Exodus. We are called to come out of the world and out of Babylon and walk that path towards the holy mountain in a similar pattern. The Israelites walked to Mount Sinai. Now we are walking to Mount Zion, a mountain that will come down at the sixth seal for all to see. That's the reason why in the book of Revelation is written that at the sixth seal they're all hiding in caves, because they see not only God the Father but also Jesus Christ coming down with Mount Zion. And they are very much afraid, because they are afraid how will stand it the rest of the lamp. And the rest of the lamp is then the beginning trumpet judgments and the trumpet tribulations. But we have now a work to do. We have now to come together and walk towards Mount Zion. And during that walk, we have to win souls, but we have to do it in unity, and we have to do it by sharing resources, and we have to do it by supporting one another. Not only the needy, the poor, but also the children, and in this case also baby Grace. So come forth and open your heart and share. Help, support. You are a true Christian, a true son and daughter of the Most High. So open your heart and share and support. This is how they walked the wilderness. Faith, protection. They walked as commanded. They followed God ahead and the archangel Michael behind. They shared resources. They supported one another. And they walked in unity. And one thing more was there, what is also amazing, is were they all in one group? No, they had 12 tribes, right? So they had 12 camps. 12 camps, that reminds me of societies of the horse. Different camps, but they all are in unity. They're all coming together for the same purpose. They all had everything in common. But they were still separated in camps, in tribes. And so we are still separated in societies of the host worldwide, but we are still in one unit together, walking that path to Mount Zion. This is how you walk in the wilderness. We have all the examples of the Israelites in the Exodus and in the book of Acts. And the Lord is saying we should copy it. Praise the Lord. You are God's chosen people. So let us come together and follow the example. Come out of the world and out of Babylon. And let us assemble as a multitude clothed in white at Mount Zion at the sixth seal to be raptured into paradise. Thank you that you have listened to this topic today. May God bless you and your family abundantly. Please consider to support baby Grace or so into our ministry, whatever you think is better. But let baby Grace heal completely. Open up your heart, your soul and your mind to come and support. The link is in the first pinned comment. Thank you for your help. And I hope I will see you again tomorrow. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.